Okay, if you're using Google Sheets and you want to find the week number of a certain date, ISOWEEKNUM might be the right function for you. Might be. So we're going to look at an example here. If we want to find the week number of March 4th, 2016, let's try ISOWEEKNUM. So the ISO calendar is a little bit different than the US calendar. And the big difference that this function is taking into consideration is that these weeks start on Monday. So if you have a date that's a Sunday, if you're using just the week number function instead of the ISOWEEKNUM, it's going to come up with a different result. But in this case, let's look up March 4, 2016. It's pretty easy what's going on here. Just close the parentheses. It's going to return a number. So this is the ninth week of 2016. It's starting over at counting one on the first week of that year that contains a Thursday, and each week is starting on a Monday. Now, this function works just fine, right? But you'll notice if you do ISO week number and you just type in 3, 4, 16, it's not gonna work right. It looks like it's working right. It returns a number that could be the result. But what this is doing ISO week number 3 divided by 4 divided by 16. So there's only three ways in which you can get this to work right. You can do it as a cell reference, like I had it set up before. So if you just do it as B7 and type enter, that returns 9. You could put the date in quotes. So if you put a quote in here and do 3, 4, 16. And let's hit enter, that also returns 9. The third way to do these date functions so that you get an accurate result is to put it together with another date related function inside of it. So let's go down to cell E13 and look at how I'm getting this result. Is I'm using a date function inside of ISOWEEKNUM. So ISOWEEKNUM is looking for a valid date. Well, if you're using a date function inside of it that's set up properly, it's automatically going to return something that makes sense to ISOWEEKNUM, and it can use that. And then here I've set it up so that the day, month, and year are in separate cells. This may be the case depending on what data you're starting with. And this would be how to combine them. So take the ISOWEEKNUM, put the year, month, and day together, and that'll give you your result. So if you're looking to count week numbers, but you want to start the weeks on Sunday instead of Monday, look into the weeknum function instead of the ISOWEEKNUM. It works very similar, but with that little difference. And that's all. So if you found that video helpful and you want to see others like it, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.